We are looking at chapter number 8, which is the quadrilaterals. Triangles, we have seen triangles. What does it mean? Triangle have three sides, three angle, three vertices. And on joining three non-collinear points, these are non-collinear points, we get a triangle. Now let us take four points. These are collinear points, so it cannot, these cannot make a triangle. We have three points which are non-collinear, they can make a triangle. We have four points now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, these are also four points. And they are making quadrilaterals. Quadrilaterals, quad means four. Laterals means side. So if all the points are collinear, we obtain a line segment. If three out of these four points are collinear, we can get a triangle. If no three points out of four are collinear, we get four sides, a figure with four sides, as you can see here. So this is called as quadrilateral. Quadrilateral, again, four sides. A quadrilateral has four sides, 1, 2, 3, 4. It has four vertices, 1, 2, 3, 4. Four vertices, four sides, and four angle, 1, 2, 3, 4, four angle. And if you combine this, or if you join this, these opposite points, you get two diagonals, two diagonals. So this is how a quadrilateral is defined. So we have quadrilateral, and a quadrilateral have four vertices, four side, four angles, and two diagonals. So this is an example of a quadrilateral. This is an example of a quadrilateral. This is an example of quadrilateral. See, there are so many quadrilaterals here. There are also quadrilateral here. See, some small ones, smaller ones. This is also a quadrilateral. Angle sum property of quadrilaterals. So angle sum property of a quadrilateral says that the angle of the quadrilateral, they sum up to 360 degree. How? Now let us join. This is A, B, C, D. This is a quadrilateral. Let us join the diagonal, one diagonal. You see, we know that the triangle, the angle sum property of triangle is 180 degree. So this angle plus this angle plus this angle gives you 180 degree. This angle plus this angle plus this angle gives you 180 degree. Two triangles. Now when you add this, this plus this plus this plus this plus this plus this, it gives you 360 degree. But this whole angle is A angle. This whole angle is C angle. So A plus C plus D plus B gives you 180 plus 180. That is 360 degree. So let us try it out. See, in this quadrilateral, we have made a diagonal. We say this DAC, this angle DAC, plus ACD, this angle, plus angle D, this is equal to 180 degree. In this triangle, this CAB, which is this angle, and ACB, which is this angle, and angle B, these three adds up to 180 degree. Now let us add this 1 and 2. When we add this, D and B, let it be there, but DAC plus BAC, DAC plus BAC, it gives angle A, and DCA or ACD, or you can say this angle, then ACB or BCA, both are same. So this angle plus this angle gives you angle C. So just write DAC plus CAB equal to angle A, ACD plus ACB equal to angle C, you get four angles equal to 360 degree. So sum of the angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree. Types of quadrilateral, there are a number of type which can be made from four lines. This one, trapezium, this a sort of you can say parallelogram. It's a square, it's a rectangle. A special type of rectangle is square. Then we have a kind of parallelogram, which is rhombus. This is a kite. So just observe that one pair of opposite sides of quadrilateral, in this one, first one, ABCD. AB is, this AB is parallel to DC, CD or DC you can say. This is known as a trapezium. So one pair of opposite sides of a quadrilateral is parallel, it is called trapezium. Come to second one. Both pairs of opposite sides are parallel. This is parallel to this one, this is parallel to this one. this is a parallelogram, right? So quadrilateral PQRS is a parallelogram. So all quadrilaterals after this, this are parallelograms. Come to the third one. In this, the angles, which is this one, all the angles are 90 degrees. So this is called as a rectangle. Now here we come, this one. So in this, all the sides are equal, and this is a parallelogram also. So a parallelogram where all sides are equal is known as rhombus. Now let us come to this one. This is a square. How? All angle 90 degree and all sides equal. This side equal, and all the angles are 90 degrees. So this is a square. Then we have a kite. The kite in this, this side is equal to this side, and this side is equal to this side, right? So in this, the two adjacent sides are equal, that is two pairs of adjacent sides are equal, and it is not a parallelogram. It is not a parallelogram, so it is called a kite. So let us assume and let us resume actually. Square, rectangle, rhombus, they all are parallelograms. A square is a rectangle and also a rhombus. A parallelogram is a trapezium. A kite is not a parallelogram, and a trapezium is not a parallelogram. A rectangle or a rhombus is not a square. Look at this figure. We have a rectangle and a parallelogram with same perimeter. 3 plus 4 plus 3 plus 4. And again 3 plus 4 plus 3 plus 4. So you see that the area of this parallelogram will be simply, or you can say the area of this rectangle will be length into breadth, so 4 into 3. But how about this area? The area is 3 into this height. Area of parallelogram is base into height. So AP into DP, you have to find DP. Okay. Just like burfis or sweets, you will find is in the shape of this. Properties of parallelogram. This is a parallelogram. Parallelogram has opposite side parallel. That is why it is called a parallelogram. And if you join a quadrilateral, which is a parallelogram, the diagonal, we see that it divides, this diagonal divides it into two triangles. When you place this triangle over this triangle, they will superimpose. That means this triangle is congruent to this triangle. How these two are congruent? See, first of all, take this triangle. This is a common side. And because these lines are parallel, this angle is equal to this angle, and this angle is equal to this angle because of the transversal parallel line property. So we have this angle equal to this one, this angle equal to this angle, and this angle equal to this angle. So these two are congruent. That means when they are two are congruent, they are exactly of same side. This side is equal to this side. This side is equal to this side. So a diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. So exactly same thing which I told you. We join A and C, and this A and C divides two triangles. And this triangle is ABC and CDA. So there are two triangles, ABC, this one, and CDA. Now, because these are parallel, DC and AB are parallel, this angle is equal to this angle, that is BCA is equal to DAC. Again, this angle is equal to this angle, that is the BAC equal to DCA. And because this line is common, so we say AC equal to CA. That is why these two triangles are congruent. So when they are congruent, we say that the diagonal of a parallelogram divides the quadrilateral, which is now the parallelogram, into two congruent triangles, ABC and CD. Now just measure the opposite side. As we say, these are congruent, so this is equal to this, this is equal to this. So AB becomes equal to DC and AD becomes equal to BC. This is one of the property of parallelogram. In a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. We have already proven this, two triangles are congruent when we divide it by a diagonal. So the opposite sides are equal. So if each pair of opposite sides of a quadrilateral is equal, then it is a parallelogram. How to prove this? See, first of all, let us take a quadrilateral. Each pair of opposite side of a quadrilateral is equal. This side is equal to this side is equal to this side. So when we take these two triangles, this side equal to this side, this side equal to this side, and this is common. So they are congruent. When they are congruent, this angle will be equal to this angle equal to this angle. And that is only possible when DC and AB are parallel, right? So when they are parallel, then only this is going to be a parallelogram, and that is a parallelogram. Okay. In a parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. Opposite angles are equal. How to prove this? We'll try and make the quadrilateral, and then we'll try to prove it. See, if in a quadrilateral each pair of opposite angles are equal, then it is a parallelogram. We can just prove it, but let us try it. In a parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. How? It's quite easy, because this line is parallel to this line, so this angle equal to this angle. This angle equal to this angle. This is common, right? So these two triangles are congruent. When they are congruent, this angle has to be equal to this angle. So opposite sides are equal. And if you want to find out these angles, just make this as a diagonal. Again, because this is a parallelogram, internal opposite angle will be equal, internal opposite angle will be equal. This is a common, so these two triangles are congruent by ASA rule. And since these are congruent, this angle has to be equal to this angle. So in parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. If in a quadrilateral each pair of opposite angle is equal, then it is a parallelogram. So we are saying that this angle is equal to this angle. So let us again join the diagonal. This angle is equal to this angle. This is a common side, right? This is a common side, and we have to prove that it is a parallelogram. So how to prove it? We know that opposite sides are equal. So this side is equal to this side. This side is equal to this side. So by SAS, we have just proved it. So SAS and SAS, these two are congruent. When they are congruent, this angle will be equal to this angle. This angle will be equal to this angle. That means the triangles are having equal angles, and this is only possible. These two angles are only possible when these two lines are parallel. The diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. So how do they bisect each other? Let us first make a parallelogram and make the diagonals also. So A and C is one diagonal, and D and B is another diagonal. So we have two diagonals. How do they bisect? Can we take some other angle, some way of having it? Okay, so let us see. We have a converse also. If the diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other, then it is a parallelogram. First, let us try to prove this. If the diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other, then it is a parallelogram. So here in this case, it is given that this DO equal to OB and AO equal to OC. So if they take this triangle AOB and COD, this two triangle, this side equal to this side, this side equal to this side, this is vertically opposite angle. And these are vertically opposite angle, that means these two are congruent, and they are congruent, and these are shown as bisecting. This angle will be equal to this angle. This angle will be equal to this angle. That is only possible. And these two are parallel. These two are parallel. And these two are parallel. That means it is a parallelogram. Now, we were saying that the diagonals of a parallelogram, they bisect each other. So we have to prove this is equal to this or this is equal to this. So let us take triangle AOD and triangle BOC. In this, we know that this is a parallelogram. So this angle is equal to this angle. This angle is equal to this angle. And this angle equal to this angle. So this is vertically opposite. So by AAA, we can say these two triangles are congruent. That means DO equal to OB, AO equal to OC. Right? Now let us take certain example. Show that each angle of a rectangle is a right angle. So what is a rectangle? A rectangle is a parallelogram in which one angle is a right angle. So let ABCD, this be a quadrilateral or a rectangle with 90 degree. And we know that in a parallelogram, because it is a parallelogram, right? And we can just say that this if this is 90 degree, we just need to prove that this is 90, this is 90, this is 90, this is 90. We can easily say that this, because this is a parallelogram, we know that rectangle is a parallelogram, which with one angle is a right angle. So opposite angles are equal, so angle A will be equal to angle C. Right, and angle D will be equal to angle B. So we say A and C are equal, and we don't know about D and B. So let us take it as x, and this is 90, so this is 90. So x plus 90 plus 90, We know that the sum of the quadrilateral angle of 360 degree, x plus x is what? 2x will be equal to 90, 90 is 180, 180 take it here. So 360 minus 180, 2x will be 180, x is equal to 90 degree. So these two angles are also 90 degree. There are other ways of also doing this. We can just take A and B, this A and B, because these are basically linear, the interior angles of the same side of a traversal. So if this is two parallel lines, so if you draw this and this has to be equal to, addition of this has to be 180 degree. So let us prove it in another way. This angle A plus angle B is what? 180 degree. Angle A is 90 degree. So what this angle will be? 90 degree. And we know that opposite angles are also equal. So this angle will be 90 degree. This angle are 90 degree. So this is another way of proving that the each angle of a rectangle is a right angle. Show that the diagonals of a rhombus are perpendicular to each other. So we have to show that these are perpendicular to each other. So just consider this rhombus, and in this rhombus we know that the sides, all sides are equal. So AD will be equal to DC equal to BC equal to AC, right? And we have to show that the diagonals are perpendicular to each other. And we know that the diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. This is equal to this. This is equal to this, right? So let us take triangle AOD, this one, and COD, this one and this one, this one and this one. And this side is equal to this side because the diagonal bisect each other. This is a common side. This side is equal to this side. So you can say that by SSS congruency theorem, this is equal to this. And this angle and this angle are to be equal. Means this angle is equal to this angle. And this plus this means x plus x, because they are linear pair, they has to be equal to 180 degree. So x will be equal to 180 by 2. That is, it will be 90 degrees. So this is 90, 90, and if you take these two triangles, this also be 90, this also be 90. This is how it is proved that the diagonals of a rhombus are perpendicular to each other. ABC is an isosceles triangle, this A, B and C. Isosceles means this side equal to this side, in which AB equal to AC. So this AB is equal to AC, and AD bisects exterior angle. AD is bisecting the exterior angle PAC. And CD is, this side is parallel to AB. We have to prove that DAC equal to BCA. Means this angle DAC, this angle equal to BCA, this angle. And also ABCD is a parallelogram. So let us start with this. ABC is an isosceles, and these two sides are given equal. See, since these two sides are equal, that this bank angle B and angle C has to be equal to each other, because opposite sides of an equal sides, opposite angle of the equal side are going to be equal. So B and C are equal. So what is this PAC? This PAC is simply ABC, because this ABC total, I am talking about PAC. This PAC will be equal to ABC. Why? Because this, as I said, that this will be equal to ABC plus ACB. ABC plus AC, this whole angle is an exterior angle. An exterior angle is equal to interior opposite angle. So this whole angle will be equal to the angle B plus angle C, that is PAC will be equal to ABC plus ACB. But we have just seen ABC and ACB are equal, so we can just write twice ACB. So this twice ACB, PAC equal to twice ACB. Now AD is bisecting this whole angle. So what is this angle? PAC. So PAC, AD is bisecting. So PAC is simply 2 into DAC, twice of this, because this is equal to this. And from this, 2 DAC will be equal to 2 ACB. Cut these 2, DAC become equal to ACB. So this DAC has become equal to ACB, which is equivalent to ABC. Now the second part. Now these angles, equal angles, form a pair of alternate angles when line segment this BC and AD are intersected by a transversal, which is this AC, whole AC. So now this angle becomes equal to this angle. You are saying by yourself, this angle equal to this angle. This side is parallel to this side, and similarly this side will be equal to this side, parallel to this side. So both the sides of a quadrilateral is parallel. That is why this ABCD is a parallelogram. Two parallel lines, this L and M, are intersected by a transversal, this P, show that the quadrilateral formed by the bisectors of interior angles is a rectangle. So we have two lines, there is a transversal, all the bisector, this bisector, this bisector, this bisector, this bisector, when they intersect, they are making a form, means like a figure. You have to show that the quadrilateral which is formed by these bisectors of interior angle is actually rectangle. So let us see. It is given that this PS is parallel to QR, like line L and M are parallel. P is intersecting or transversal. So the bisector of PAC means this angle, and ACQ, this angle, ACQ. They are meeting at B, and the bisector of this angle are meeting at D. We have to show that PAC equal to ACR, that is this PAC, this angle is equal to ACR, this angle, right? So PAC and ACR has to be equal. Why? Why? Because these two are parallel and these are internal opposite angle. Similarly, this angle will also be equal to this angle. Let us do it first one by one. This PAC equal to ACR, let us half it. Half is what? Half of PAC, because this is angle bisector. Half of PAC will be equal to BAC, this angle, and half of ACR, that is half of ACR will be what? This ACD, this one. So BAC become equal to ACD. Similarly, we'll take the other pair, right? So they are actually forming a pair of alternate angles. So AB is parallel to DC, and similarly BC equal to BC is parallel to AD. We can consider these two triangles, A or say angle. ACB, this one ACB, and this CAD, this angle, right? Similarly, we have to do this like this, because same stuff we will do. What we have done here is, similarly we will do same thing, because this is equal to this, so we will say whole this one will be equal to this one when we did this thing. This is equal to this, and we will just make it half. So this A, this angle and this angle will be half half of this will be equal. So ultimately, because these two are parallel, we just show that if this angle is equal to this angle and this angle is equal to this angle, that means this line is parallel to this line is parallel to this line, which is shown here. So now this will come to this is a parallelogram. This is being proved. Now PAC, say this PAC, this total one, PAC, total one, plus CAS. What is this CAS? This CAS. These two are going to form what? These are the linear pair, because we have a line. So this angle and this angle will be 180 degree. So in the case of PAC, just multiply half both sides. The PAC half is what? BAC. We have already proved it. This is simply BAC, this one, and half of CAS. And half of CAC is simply this CAD, right? So just multiply total expression by half. Half of PAC is BAC, half of CAC is CAD, half of 180 degree is 90 degree. And when these two angle sum to 90 degree, that means we have a parallelogram with one angle 90 degree, which is of course rectangle. Show that the bisectors of angles of a parallelogram form a rectangle. So we have bisector of angle of a parallelogram. So we have A, B, C, D as a parallelogram. We have a bisector, and when this is a bisector, this is a bisector, this is a bisector, and when they intersect, S, R, P, Q are the points, and this has to be shown that is a rectangle. So how to show this? First of all, in triangle ASD, just see ASD, this triangle. Since this DS is bisecting angle D, and AS is bisecting angle A, so we can say that this DAS means this one, DS plus this ADS will be equal to, because this is half of A, we can write half of A. In this ADS, we can write half of D, right? So half of D we can write, take half outside, A plus D. But if these two are parallel, this angle and this angle are supplementary, so A plus D is 90 degree, 180 degree. So A plus D is 180 degree. 90 degree divided by 2, this is 90 degree. So one angle will be, this angle has become 90 degree, we have just got this DAS plus ADS 90 degree. So if these two are 90 degree, this has to be 90 degree by Angle-Sum property. And because these two are vertically opposite angle, this has to be 90 degree. Similarly, you can prove it for this also, so 90 degree, 90 degree. When one of the angle is 90 degree and this side is parallel to this side, we say that these are, and just simply what I proved, right? So it is the this internal structure is a parallelogram. Another condition for quadrilateral to be a parallelogram. So we have seen many properties of parallelogram, and we have verified that if a quadrilateral, the properties we have satisfied, it becomes a parallelogram. But there are certain situations where we don't require those many conditions. We can just prove by some of the conditions that it is a parallelogram. A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if a pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. In this figure, AB is equal to CD, and this AB is parallel to CD. So just draw a diagonal, and you can show easily that these two are congruent. How? This side is equal to this side, this angle is equal to this angle, right? And this is common. So SAS, you can say that these two are congruent. Now let us apply this property to our question and use the example to prove what we have seen. See, in this example, ABCD is a parallelogram. So ABCD is a parallelogram in which this P is the midpoint, Q is the midpoint of opposite side AB and CD. If AQ intersect DP, means this AQ, this and this, intersect DP at S and BQ at this BQ at R. So we have to show that APCQ, means this whole APCQ, is a parallelogram. DPBQ, means this one, DPBQ is a parallelogram. PSQR inside, PSQR are parallelogram. So let us start one by one. In this APCQ, AP and CNQ, AP is parallel to this, AP is parallel to QC because they are parallel already, it is a parallelogram, right? And AP is given to be half of AB because this is midpoint. AP is half of AB, so you can write half AB, AP, and QC is half of CD. This is whole CD, this is half of CD. And when you equate this, it is simply because AB is simply equal to DC because they are parallelogram. So AP will also be equal to CQ. These two are equal. Now these two are equal, right? So APCQ becomes a parallelogram, right? Opposite side are equal, and they are, opposite sides are parallel and equal also. So that is why it is a parallelogram. You can similarly prove it for others, second one also. But in this you have proved APCQ. You can prove it for PBDQ. And now let us prove it for PQSR, middle one, PQSR. In this, this SP and QR are, these are parallel because we have just proved that this is a parallelogram. This is parallel to this, right? And also we have just proved that this is also parallelogram. So this is parallel to this, opposite side are parallel, so this is a parallelogram.
The midpoint theorem. So we have seen the triangles and the quadrilaterals. Now let us see what is the midpoint theorem when it pertains to triangle. This says, let us make start with an activity. We draw a triangle. Mark the point E and F on the two sides of a triangle, and we join EF. Now we measure this EF, the length of EF, and measure the length of BC. If you actually do it, and you can measure this angle also, this angle and this angle. If you measure it, EF will be half of BC, or you can say BC is twice of EF, and this angle AEF will be equal to angle ABC. So EF is equal to half, is equal to twice of or half of BC, and AF is parallel to BC because these angles, corresponding angles, are equal. So what we got here is the two line segment joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle is parallel to third side. Now we just did an activity. Now we need to prove it. So how to prove it? In this figure, this E and F we are saying are the midpoints of the triangle, and this AB and AC are the two sides whose midpoint are E and F. And now we have made a construction where CD is now parallel to AB, right? Now from this, since these two are parallel, this side is parallel, this we have made a construction. So this angle is equal to this angle is equal to this angle, and these are vertically opposite angles. So what is happening here is we are saying that AE equal to FD or DF, you can say EF equal to DF, and since this whole ED is equal to BC by construction, so if EF is equal to FD and ED is equal to BC, that means FD and ED both are equal to half of DC, okay, half of DC. Or you can say that since EF equal to DF and BE, this BE equal to AE, because this is a midpoint, and this is equal to DC, so this is equal to this. So now BCDE means BCDE is a parallelogram, which gives BE parallel to CD because it has been made, and EF parallel to BC. So EF is parallel to BC because of parallelogram, and EF is half of AD, or you can say half of BC. This whole AD is equal to BC because of parallelogram, and therefore EF is half of AD. The line drawn through the midpoint of one side of a triangle parallel to another side bisects the third side. So this is the converse of what we have seen in this figure. We see that the E is the midpoint of AB, and L is a line passing through E, this line, which is parallel to BC. This happens to be parallel to BC. And CM, this CM, this hole is parallel to AB. We have to prove that this AF equal to CF. This is the midpoint using the congruence. So we'll take two triangle. One is your AEF and another is your CDF. Right? So again, congruency rule we can apply easily. I'll show you how. So this angle is vertically opposite. This angle is equal to this angle. This angle is equal to this angle because these are parallel. And you can easily prove this. I hope I leave this as an exercise for you. Now, next is example. So what we have seen, let us prove it by example. In this triangle ABC, this DEF are the midpoints of side AB, BC and CA. We have to show that this triangle ABC is divided into four congruent triangles by joining DEF. So 1, 2, 3, 4, these are congruent. So as this D and E, these are the midpoints of side AB, we know that DE is parallel to AC, and DE is also half of AC, right? This we know by midpoint theorem. So DE is parallel to AC, and DE is parallel to BC. DF is parallel to BC, and EF is parallel to AB. So now this ADEF A, and this one DFEBD, and this one, these all are parallelograms, three parallelograms, and we know that DE, this one is the parallelogram of this. This is the diagonal of this parallelogram. So DE is the diagonal of BEFD, right? So now D is diagonal of parallelogram VDFE. Therefore, this triangle is congruent to this triangle. How? This angle is equal to this angle equal to this angle, opposite angles are equal, these two are congruent. Similarly, these two are congruent, similarly, these two are congruent. When four are congruent, that means all the four are equal and congruent. That means this triangle ABC is divided into 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 congruent triangles by joining DEF. Now LMN, these are three parallel lines intersected by transversal P and Q, such that L, M and N cutoff equal intercept AB, this AB and BC on P. We have to show that this L, M and N cutoff equal intercept DE and EF also. So we are given that AB equal to BC and we have to prove that DE is equal to EF also. So let us join this A and F. This and this needs to be joined. Okay. This line intersect M at G. So we have trapezium ACFD. Please consider this trapezium A and C and F and D. In this AD is parallel to CF. AD is parallel to BE. Now this ACF, A, C and F. This is a triangle and AFD, AFD. So in this ACF, this is a line. B is the midpoint because AB is BC given. This is the midpoint and this line are parallel. So this point is also midpoint of AF. So AG becomes equal to GF. G is the midpoint, right? Now take this triangle AFD. So AFD. G is the midpoint and a line which is drawn parallel to this line is also the midpoint of E, because if this is parallel to the base and it is a midpoint, then this will also be midpoint. So E is the midpoint of DF, so DE become equal to EF. Let us summarize what we have seen. This is quadrilateral. Summarize it. Sum of angles of quadrilateral is, if you add these, you are going to get 360 degree. The diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles, this and this, two congruent triangles. In a parallelogram, the opposite sides are equal, opposite angles are equal, this equal to this, and diagonals bisect each other, this equal to this, this equal to this. A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if opposite sides are equal, opposite angles are equal, and diagonal bisect each other, or a pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. Diagonals of a rectangle bisect each other and are equal. Diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other at right angles and also vice versa. Diagonals of square bisect each other at right angles and are equal. A line joining the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side and a half of it. This is called midpoint theorem. A line through the midpoint of a side of a triangle parallel to another side bisect the third side. Again, the converse of midpoint theorem. And a quadrilateral formed by joining the midpoints of a side of a quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So this is all about this chapter. Thank you so much and take care of yourself.